There it is. My underground house.
Where is it? I can't see it.
It's right there. The house right there. Come on, we'll go inside. Welcome to my humble abode.
Wow, this is really neat. Lots of windows. Really got good light in here. Good temperature, too.
Yeah.
It's cool.
And you should do it on a hot day.
Yeah.
Okay, from these posts over, that was my original house that I built for $50.
Okay.
And I lived in for 4 or 5 years before I added on another section. This is the original bed area here, and this is called the fire window because we used to have campfires out there at night. They're open right now. I got too much pine needles out there, but we had campfires out there at night.
Mm-hmm.
Until we discovered it was smoky in here because it was drawing right up through the roof. And so we stopped doing campfires there. And instead we did campfires behind you. Open those windows. Those are called the barbecue windows.
Okay.
And you can cook outside in the rain. And you're inside out of the rain. And you can cook outside on a cold winter day. And you're inside warm in the house. And you can cook on a hot day out there.
Yeah.
And you stay inside the house nice and cool.
Nice.
So this out here is the uphill patio.
Okay.
And that's the secret on these houses. It gives us a huge blast of light in what otherwise would be a big dark area. This was the original door on the $50 house. I didn't have a carpet on the floor in those days, and in fact this was not excavated out here. This was the area in here. It was the same level as this here, and instead of a carpet on the floor, we just had straw on the floor.
And then you would come down through this door?
Yeah, we'd come down through there. Due to an engineering error on my part, these walls started pushing in on us, and I had a choice. I could either repair that, dig it out and repair it, or I could add on to the house. So I did. I added these two sections at once on the place, and then I put wall-to-wall carpeting in the whole thing, and that addition cost another $500, and that included $200 for the cost of the wall-to-wall carpeting.
Oh, really?
Yeah. It didn't have this fancy stove then. I just had a tin stove, it was called, that originally sold for $15. And this thing, we put this in, that was a $500 stove there. And then we also put in some solar electricity in the place, $1,000 for the solar voltaic system. And so actually, when you get done with everything, this whole house cost $2,000. But I lived in it for another 30 years then.
Yeah. Not bad for a house.
No. So what they're paying for a month for an apartment in New York these days.
I know.
Yeah. So I got 30 years of use out of it. And I've got a nice comfortable chair. Yeah. This is one of my favorite places in this house for sure. And it stays nice and warm up here. Because that heat is rising up from the stove. The bedroom in there is a little chilly. I don't mind it, but sometimes guys do. So we have lots of things to snuggle under there. When my book first came out in 1978, we were running the whole business out of here. I ran a phone line up here. I would carry the books over the hill, put them together up here for mailing, and then carry them back down again, and that got old pretty quick.
Yeah.
So, that's pretty much it for this house. There is a, beneath this here is a root cellar.
Keep food and stuff?
Yep. Keeps it real good. This is my writing area, and where we originally filled out the book orders. And it was really hard right here at night with just kerosene lights. Mm-hmm. So once we got the solar voltaic system in, it was a big help. Yeah. That system's down now. The batteries are finally wore out. Second set of batteries there. But my electrician guy was amazed that the batteries lasted 14 years.
Oh, really?
Yeah, usually about 10 years. The problem on that around here is when you need the lights the most in the wintertime, we don't have much sun. I'm hoping on the ridge house we're going to be able to have a lot more solar panels and eventually a wind generator.
Okay.
Well, let's take another little trip. Let's go up on the roof of the house. Once I actually had I was in the house and I heard some people walking over my roof.
Yeah.
And a gal said, "Well, where's the house?" And I had people walk into the house and see all those windows on the uphill patio.
Yeah.
And say, "I thought we were underground." So that's kind of neat.
It's pretty hidden.
Yeah. So, now you know, there's the underground house.